Hello students, welcome to today's class. Today we will discuss the topic Pascal's law and hydraulic machines. All the hydraulic machines are based on the topic Pascal's law. So Pascal's law is the principle of all the hydraulic machines. So Pascal's law states that in a confined liquid, confined means enclosed liquid, in a confined liquid the pressure exerted anywhere is transmitted equally and undiminished throughout the liquid. So Pascal's law states that the pressure exerted anywhere in a confined or enclosed liquid is transmitted equally and undiminished throughout the liquid. So first of all, we will see an experiment demonstrating Pascal's law. So this is the experimental setup demonstrating Pascal's law. So here you can see a glass flask. This is a glass flask having narrow tubes, coming out from the side and the bottom. So these are the narrow tubes coming from the bottom and from the sides. The flask is provided, with an airtight piston. You can see here, the flask is provided with an airtight piston at its mouth. So fill the flask with water. So water is filled inside the flask. The water in each tube will be at the same level. The initial level of water in each tube is same. Now push the piston down into the flask gently. It is observed that jets of water rises out from each tube, reaching the same height. So you can see that when the piston is pushed downward, the water is coming out from each tube with the same pressure. This shows that the pressure applied in an enclosed liquid is transmitted equally in all directions throughout the liquid. So this is the experimental demonstration of Pascal's law. So we have seen Pascal's law. So Pascal's law states that the pressure exerted anywhere in an enclosed liquid is transmitted equally and undiminished throughout the liquid. So all the hydraulic machines are based on Pascal's law. So when a small force is applied on a smaller piston and when it is transmitted to a larger piston, that time the force also becomes large. So this is the principle of a hydraulic machine. Now we are going to derive the formula of hydraulic machine. So all the hydraulic machines consist of two cylinders. So these are two cylinders. All the hydraulic machines consist of two cylinders. One is of smaller area of cross section and another one is of larger area of cross section. So this is a cylinder with a smaller area cross section. That cylinder's area cross section is taken as A1, and this is a cylinder of larger area of cross section. That is, area of cross section is taken as A2. And these two cylinders are provided with piston. You can see pistons at the top. Pistons. It is provided with the pistons. And these two cylinders are interconnected with each other with a connecting pipe. So this is the diagram of a hydraulic machine. If we take any hydraulic machine like hydraulic press, hydraulic brake, or hydraulic jack, all the cases there are two cylinders. So all the hydraulic machine consists of two cylinders. One of smaller area of cross section and another one of larger area of cross section. And both are interconnected and they are enclosed. It is fully closed. It is not exposed. And both are provided with a piston. So this is a cylinder of smaller area of cross section and its area is taken as A1. And this is a larger piston, larger cylinder. And its area cross section is A2. Then a force F1 is applied. A force F1 is applied in downward direction to this piston. A force F1 is applied. So you know the formula of pressure. Pressure is equal to force upon area. So the pressure which is applied on this smaller piston, that is equal to force applied on this piston upon area of cross section of this one. So that will come as F1 divided by A1. So the pressure which is applied on P1, that is F1 upon A1. So this when a force is applied in downward direction on this piston, this piston moves downward and a pressure is created, and this pressure is transmitted to the larger cylinder through this connecting pipe, and the pressure which is reaching here and the force which is produced here, that is taken as F2. The force which is produced here, that is taken as F2. And the pressure which is produced on the larger cylinder, that is taken as P2. So that which is equal to F2 upon A2. According to the Pascal's law, the pressure exerted anywhere in an enclosed liquid, is transmitted equally. So that is, therefore P1 is equal to P2. So we can write F1 upon A1 is equal to F2 upon A2. So on cross multiplying and changing the position, we can also write F1 by F2 is equal to A1 by A2. So on cross multiplying this, F1 A2 is equal to F2 A1, or F1 by F2 which is equal to A1 by A2. So this is the formula of hydraulic machine. So F1 is the force which is applied on the smaller piston, and A1 is the area cross section of the smaller piston, and F2 is the force which is produced on the largest piston, and A2 is the area cross section of the larger piston. So when a smaller force is applied on the smaller piston, and when it reaches to the larger piston, that time the force becomes large. So this is the principle. Now we can see an example. Suppose the area cross section of this one A1, that is taken as 10 cm square, and the force which is applied on the smaller piston, that is taken as suppose 20 Newton, F1 is taken as 20 Newton. And suppose at the area cross section of larger piston, that is suppose it is 150 centimeter square. Suppose it is 150 centimeter square. Then how much force is produced on larger piston? Let us substitute the values in this formula. So F1 is equal to 20 Newton. And F2, we have to find it out. And A1 is 10 centimeter square. And A2 is 150 centimeter square. Centimeter square cancel. Then cross multiplying. Then we get F2 is equal to 15 into 20 Newton. So that is equal to 300 Newton. So here you can see that only a force of 20 Newton. A force of 20 Newton is applied on the smaller piston. But when it reaches to the larger piston, that force multiplied many times, the force becomes 300 Newton. So if the area cross section of this cylinder is more, then the magnitude of force which is produced will be more. So this is the principle of hydraulic machine. Hydraulic machines are based on the principle of Pascal's law, which states that the pressure exerted anywhere in an enclosed liquid is transmitted equally and undiminished throughout the liquid. Means when a force is applied on a smaller piston and when it reaches to the larger cylinder, larger piston, that force becomes large. So now we will see a number of hydraulic machines and its working. So this is the diagram of a hydraulic press. Hydraulic press. So it also, like all hydraulic machines, it consists of two cylinders. So this cylinder named as P, cylinder P. And this is another cylinder which is named as cylinder Q. Cylinder P, cylinder Q. Cylinder P is of smaller area of cross section and cylinder Q is of larger area of cross section. And these two cylinders P and Q are connected each other with a connecting pipe. So you can see both the cylinders P and Q are connected with a connecting pipe. And at the top of the cylinder P, you can see a piston. So this is the piston. So, and this piston that is provided with a lever arrangement. You can see a lever arrangement. So you can see a handle. So lever arrangement is there. This lever can be moved downward and upward. And at the bottom of the cylinder P, you can see a valve. This valve is named as V1. And at the bottom, below this cylinder, there is a water supply tank. So this is a water supply tank. And from this water supply tank, there is also a connection given to the cylinder Q. Here you can see this connection. So this is the... this way it is connected. And at the top of this cylinder Q is of larger area of cross section. Cylinder Q, that is of larger area of cross section. And cylinder P is of smaller area of cross section. And at the top of the cylinder Q, there is a piston. This is known as press plunger. And this one is a pump plunger. So this is the press plunger, and at the top of this piston we keep any object which is to be pressed, and at the above that there is a fixed support that cannot be moved. Suppose that if you have to make a bale of cotton, then cotton is kept at the top of this press plunger, and it will be moved upward and will get pressed with the fixed support, and it will change into sheets of cotton. So this is the arrangement of hydraulic press. Now we will see its working of hydraulic press. So first of all, this lever is lifted upward. This lever is lifted upward. Or the pump plunger is raised by raising the handle. Then, due to the then what will happen? The pressure in cylinder P decreases and the valve V1 opens. When the valve V1 opens, the water from the reservoir tank is pushed up into the cylinder P. So this way water comes inside the cylinder P. So this way water is filled. Now the next step, first step is lever is raised up. When the lever is raised up, the valve V1 opens and water from the supply tank comes inside. The next step is the lever is pushed downward. When the lever is pushed downward, the valve V1 will be closed and the pressure which is created here, that will be the pressure which is produced here, that is transmitted to cylinder Q. The pressure which is produced here, that is transmitted to cylinder Q. Then valve V2 will open. The valve V2 will open and it will reach here. And an upward force is produced. Due to this upward force, this piston B or press plunger or ram, that will move upward. And the things which are kept on the press plunger, like bale of cotton, that will get compressed with the fixed support. So this is the working of hydraulic press. Then some of the uses of hydraulic press. It is used for pressing cotton bales and goods like quilt, books, etc. It is also used for extracting the juice from sugar cane, sugar beet, etc. It is also used for squeezing out oil of linseed and cotton seed. It is also used for engraving monograms on goods. These are all some of the uses of hydraulic press. Now the next topic is hydraulic jack or hydraulic lift. So this is the diagram of a hydraulic jack. So like all other hydraulic machine, it also consists of two cylinders. So here the cylinders are named as P and Q. Cylinder P is of smaller area of cross section and cylinder Q is of larger area of cross section. Then both are provided with piston. You can see piston A, that is provided with the cylinder P. Cylinder P has a piston which is named as A. And the cylinder Q, that is the larger cylinder, that has a piston which is named as piston B. So piston B, that is also provided with a platform. And piston A, that is provided with a lever arrangement. So this is the diagram of a hydraulic jack or hydraulic lift. Now we see the working of hydraulic jack, how a hydraulic jack works. When handle lever is pressed downward, by applying an effort, here this handle is moved downward. Then due to that, the piston A will move downward. And a pressure is created. So seeing the working. So first this handle is moved downward. Then the piston A moves downward. And a pressure is produced, and due to this pressure, the valve V opens. Then the liquid runs out of the cylinder P to the cylinder Q. As a result, the piston B rises up. And it raises the car placed on the platform. Due to the pressure, the piston B rises and platform along with the car also rises. When the car reaches to the desired height, the handle of the lever is no longer pressed. The valve gets closed so that the liquid may not run back from the cylinder Q to the cylinder P. So this is the working of a hydraulic jack. So like all hydraulic machine, it also consists of two cylinders, one of smaller area cross section, other one of larger area cross section, and this is the arrangement to move this car upward. First this handle is moved downward and effort is applied, then piston air moves downward and a pressure is produced. Due to this pressure, this valve opens and the water from the cylinder P goes to this cylinder Q, and due to this upward force, the piston B along with the platform moves upward. And when we have to stop this car to a desired height, moving this lever downward, we keep that lever in that particular position. So this is the working of hydraulic jack. Now the last topic is hydraulic brake. This is the diagram of a hydraulic brake. What are the main parts of hydraulic brake? So this is a foot pedal. It is a foot pedal. And near this foot pedal, there is a small cylinder, and the name of this cylinder is master cylinder. Foot pedal. So this foot pedal is connected with a piston. So this piston, it is named as piston A. So this cylinder is called master cylinder. And near the wheel, there is a larger cylinder. And its name is wheel cylinder. And this cylinder has also piston. It is also provided with a piston. That pistons are named as piston B1 and B2. And these pistons are also connected with a brake shoe. So these pistons are connected with the brake shoe. You can see brake shoe here. This is the brake shoe. On either side of the piston, you can see brake shoe. After the brake shoe, there is a rim. And these two cylinders, that is master cylinder and wheel cylinder, they are connected with a connecting pipe. And a fluid is filled inside this cylinders. So this is the diagram of hydraulic brake. Now we see the working. Suppose that we have to stop the vehicle. When we have to stop the vehicle, we will apply force on foot pedal. When we apply force on this foot pedal, force is applied. Then what will happen? This piston A, that will move inward. When piston A moves inward, a pressure is created in the master cylinder, and this pressure which is produced here, according to Pascal's law, the pressure which is produced, that is transmitted equally and undiminished throughout the liquid. And this pressure reaches here. When this pressure reaches to the wheel cylinder, the force becomes large, and an outward force is produced. And due to this outward force, the piston B1 and B2, moves outward. And along with this piston B1 and B2, this brake shoes also moves outward. Along with the piston B1 and B2, the brake shoes also moves outward. And these brake shoes get pressed with the rim of the wheel. And the wheel stop moving. So this is the working of a hydraulic brake. So today we have seen the topic Pascal's law and hydraulic machine. Next class, we will continue with another topic.